Now in question number 5, we have to construct a frequency distribution table, right? Now we have been given the cumulative frequencies, but using this column of cumulative frequency, we have to find out the value of the frequencies of each class interval. That means we have to construct a frequency distribution table. Now, you know that the first element of CF, cumulative frequency, and F, frequency is always same. So let us write this as it is. So the frequency of class interval 0 to 8 is 8. Now how do we find the what is the frequency of the next class interval 8 to 16? You know that CF of 8 to 16 is 21. And you also know this 21 is equal to the frequency of this class, let us say it is equal to x, plus the frequency of all the previous classes. In this case, only 8. So x plus 8. So this implies x is equal to 21 minus 8, which is equal to 30. So the answer is 30. Now how do we find what is the frequency of this class interval 16 to 24? You know the value of CF is 26. And so let us write 26 is equal to the frequency of this class, let us say it is equal to y, plus the frequency of all the previous classes. What is the frequency sum of all the previous sum of the frequencies of all the previous classes? It is 8 plus 13 equal to 21. So 21 implies y is equal to 26 minus 21 equals to 5. So that means you just have to subtract the consecutive cumulative frequencies. Similarly, in this case, the answer would be 33 minus 26. What is 33 minus 26? It is equal to 9. Right? So, and in next case, you have to subtract 42 minus 33. So again, the answer is 9. Now, how do we check the answer is correct? When you add all the frequencies, the answer should be equal to the last cumulative frequency equals to 42. Let us check. 8 plus 13 is equal to 21. 21 plus 5 is equal to 26. 26 plus 9 is equal to 33. And 33 plus 9 is equal to 42. So yes, our answer is correct.